Good day. My name is Christoph Haynes. I'm a professor of human rights law at the University of Pretoria, and I'm a member of the organizing committee of the Nelson Mandela World Human Rights Moot Court competition. So every year we get together around a table and we sit and think about what should the problem be, the hypothetical for the moot court for the next year. And we try to come up with interesting scenarios, and Thompson Chingeta and others eventually draft the moot problem, and we all give our inputs. And so this year we include an issue that deals with peaceful assemblies. And so I want to tell you about the background to that. So over the last couple of years, I've worked for the UN. I was a member of the Human Rights Committee. So that's the treaty body that monitors the Covenant on Civil and Political Rights. And so as you may know, the Covenant has an Article 21, a protection for the right of peaceful assembly. And the Human Rights Committee every couple of years issues a general comment. That is a document on which we've worked for the last two or so years. And in that we set out our interpretation of that particular right. So previously we did it on the right to life. And the last one we did was General Comment 37, which deals with the right of peaceful assembly. And this turned out to be exactly at the right time. So we had Black Lives Matter, and we had a lot of other demonstrations taking place worldwide. And then we, of course, decided that we want to put this issue of peaceful assemblies in the moot problem, because it reaches you, it reaches students around the world. And so in this way, we can, in a way, popularize, and we can make sure that people take note of the work of the Human Rights Committee as well. So one of the, I think one of the probably the most difficult issues that we had to deal with in drafting this general comment on Article 21 to say what do we understand with this particular right, was the question whether this right of peaceful assembly applies only offline, you know, the normal scenario where some people get together, march in the streets, hold up posters and chant and march down the street and express themselves. Does it only cover that situation where people are physically present, or does it also cover the situation where people gather online? And we're not talking about just organizing a physical gathering online, we're talking about having the actual gathering online, like MeToo. So even without people getting together physically, if they get together only online, is that protected by Article 21? So you can imagine, with 18 lawyers as we are in the Human Rights Committee and we consulted worldwide, this was a big issue. So the Human Rights Committee then took a position on this question just before COVID struck, actually March of 2020. We eventually decided on that issue on a Friday. And over that weekend, basically, COVID just became so overwhelming that everybody had to leave Geneva. But by that time, we've taken our decision. So I'm not going to say what we decided. This issue comes up in the problem. And then, of course, General Comment 37 is a good resource to use because this is an authoritative exposition of how the Human Rights Committee, the body tasked with supervising the Covenant on Civil and Political Rights, how that body understands Article 21 and whether they think that this applies also to purely online assemblies.